Yo.
Hi, I'm Max. Max's German car. This is for entertainment purposes only. I do not warranty the information contained in here. I do not warranty the completeness or the accuracy. If you choose to use this video for informational purposes, you do so at your own risk. I will not accept responsibility or liability for any injuries or damages that you might incur. Thank you. Repairing job on a 1999 Volkswagen Cabrio. Now this is the same job as any Mark III Volkswagen. That's 93 to 99, the Jetta, the Golf, or the GTI, 93 to 99 with drum brakes. It's a pretty dirty job. You gotta use grease to grease up the bearings, so it's a pretty good idea to use gloves. Put a chock on the front wheel so it doesn't move, because you have to release the emergency brake. So let's jack up the car and remove the wheel. If, of course, you don't have an impact gun, you have to loosen the lug bolts before you jack it up. But I have an impact gun, so I don't have to do that. And go ahead and do it. Is it running?
Yes.
Remember to use a jack stand. Safety first. Jack it up on level hard ground. ...17 millimeter socket to pull the lug bolts out. We've got the wheel off. We kind of pull the cap to get to the bearings. We need like a little putty knife, a beveled edge driver like this, and a hammer. Stick it in between the crevice and tap it out evenly. There's a cotter pin in here, so you have to remove the cotter pin before you do anything. If you just have a vice grip, that'll almost do. All you need is one vice grip to handle everything. You can remove your cotter pin and get the nut also with your vice grip. Pin off here. And there's a little cap that covers the nut. We have to remove the nut. Don't get it dirty. So we use our vice grip. Shouldn't be on too tight, the nut. You have it on too tight, it will be ruining your bearing. And now we can pull the whole drum off with the bearing. Be careful, your outer bearing is going to pop out. There's another little washer here. You don't want to get this dirty. Of course, we're replacing, so it doesn't matter. You pull your drum off. And here's the drum with the two bearings. This is a split bearing setup with an outer bearing and an inner bearing. So you got to replace both bearings. So the first one you want to get to is the inner bearing. You got to pull the grease seal here. You just use your screwdriver to pop that out. No, you can turn it off. Turn it on. Okay, once you get your grease seal out, you can pull out the inner bearing, which is the larger bearing. Then you have to clean all. If you're going to put new bearings on, new bearings come with what they call races, which are the outer seats for the bearings. So you're going to have to clean all the grease off with a rag. And then you get a punch and a hammer, and there's little grooves cut into the drum so you can access the race, and you can knock out the race by putting it in through this little crevice. And there's two crevices, one for each side, so. But you gotta. It's real important to clean all the grease out of the drum so that you can see what you're doing. So you can find the grooves and knock the races out. This is, of course, if you're putting new bearings in that come with races. So we gotta, you can turn it off. You can access the race with the hammer and a punch. Pound out the races. If you're putting new bearings in, you're gonna get new races. Stop. New races back in. You want to get a socket or a drift that exactly matches the diameter of the race, and then you just pound it back in.